somebody was using his name with his platform, with using his name, his own name, his original name, with his own video. Somebody did a voiceover and he was using it to defraud people, collecting money from people. And someone ever saw it. When he saw it, he came on his platform and he spoke about it. And then he mentioned the name of somebody that he was being suspected. That he suspected somebody that it is that guy that is doing it. And now, Rafael is saying that it's not that very person that is being suspected that has committed that crime. That's not the person. That's what Rafael is saying. That is not the person. So myself here, I have not investigated. I have not done the investigation. I have not searched, researched on that. I cannot tell you that this person is saying the right thing or this person is saying the wrong thing. I cannot tell you that. I cannot come here and tell you that someone about the information he gave is wrong or what Rafael is saying is the right thing. I cannot be able to verify on that. I have not made the investigation. But the only truth I know there that happened that somebody impersonated Simon Ekpa platform. Somebody impersonated the platform. That very day, Simon Ekpa released that very Facebook page. And we went inside. I clicked and I saw the page. The video the person placed there was a video of Simon Ekpa did voiceover and the person was collecting money. And that day, people were calling in. People were calling, people that the person have taken money from. They were calling in that day to complain. They were calling to complain. And Simon Ekpa said that he's going to deal with the person who is in there. He called the name of the person. I've forgotten the name. He mentioned the name of that very person. That was the person that he impersonated. But now, Rafael is saying that it's not that person that was mentioned that day that is the person making that impersonation. If it is not that person, it's another person, then we have to find out later in the day. If we find that it's not the main person that was suspected, that is another person. That he suspected somebody wrongly, it has to be corrected. It will be corrected. It is not because of that now you not come and say that someone is a demon, someone is the. But when you come to the agitation that we are talking about, the agitation that we are agitating, when you're talking about the agitation, Simon Ekpa is 100% on the same track. And Rafael himself can agree with me. Rafael can agree with me that Simon is on the same, on the track. He's doing what he's supposed to do. Because every single thing that Simon is doing today is what Rafael himself, this very person that spoke here, Rafael has supported. Rafael has supported everything that you see him speak about today. He has supported it from day one. Every single thing that Simon Ekpa is doing today, Rafael himself has supported it, which I myself have stood on the same platform with him, and we have defended Simon Ekpa. We have spoken about it. So because of one thing or the other that make him to pull out, which I don't know how he generated that so many information that came out about Rafael and whatever he did and whatever other people did, which I cannot begin to blame anybody and say this is this and this is that. I can't do that. My most concern is anything you can do to make sure that Biafra comes, continue to do that. If you know anything you can do to make Biafra come, go ahead and do that. Do not focus your attention on demonizing an individual. Don't focus your attention on blackmailing anybody. Don't blackmail anybody. It doesn't matter how big or how small the person is. Blackmail cannot help any one of us. Blackmail cannot help. Instead, it's going to destroy us. Blackmail will expose us. It will make us to look weak. I pray that Chukwu Okabia will give us the strength to continue to be with each other and support each other. When you want to talk about blackmail, there is nobody in the Biafran struggle that have been blackmailed the way someone ever have been blackmailed. Since Mazin Nanikan have been kidnapped, every blackmail that is coming is on someone ever. It takes a strong man to stand the blackmail that someone ever himself is standing. It takes an extraordinary person to withstand, to still continue to stand today and talk about Biafra. It is not everybody that can stand the blackmail that someone ever is facing. So with all that challenges and attack that's coming from there, if he makes any mistake, it is understandable. He can make a mistake. He's a human being. He is a human being. I'm not telling you that someone ever cannot make mistake. He can make mistake. It is possible. He can make a mistake. But I cannot say because he made a mistake, because of that now, I will demonize him. I will call him name. I will say I will not listen to him. I will begin to say he's demon. He's working for Fulani. No, I can't do that because I have my own common sense. I know that someone ever actually is fighting for Biafra. He is fighting for Biafra. Can he make mistake? Yes, he can make a mistake. Will the mistake be corrected? Yes, it can be corrected. It can be addressed, not out of anger. But when you see our brother Rafael is very, very angry. He said that he has been blackmailed. If he has been blackmailed, actually, nobody's going to be happy if he or she is being blackmailed. But you cannot vent that your anger to destroy that struggle that we are pursuing. You cannot out of anger. Then now you begin to destroy the struggle that every one of us is pursuing. You don't do that. He don't do that. With everything he has said here now, I myself cannot verify, I cannot walk based on what he has said. I still have to hear from the other direction. Then you begin to compare. Who was that very person impersonating someone ever? Was there somebody impersonating someone ever? There was somebody who was impersonating someone ever using his a platform in his name. That one is true, which he himself, Raphael, agreed. Somebody was a person, someone ever. But what he's saying that the person's name that was mentioned is the wrong person. That's not the person. If that person's name that was mentioned is not the right person, it can be corrected. The correction can be made. You cannot begin to demonize someone ever because of that, or you begin to call him name, say he is this, is that, begin to call him that someone ever is a demon, someone ever is this. No. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. In the struggle today, Simon Ekpa have suffered the greatest black. You're supposed to be having pity on him. Every Biafran is supposed to be having pity on him. There is nobody that will be blackmailed the way Simon Ekpa is in blackmailed. That will not make mistake. Some of us, if we are blackmailed the way Simon Ekpa is in blackmailed, we will run into our house and forget about the Biafran. After all, it's not only you. You will just run in. You will disappear. But just like I said, Biafra struggle, agitation, it is not motivational speaking. You don't just speak to motivate people. You don't just speak to make people happy. In the process of agitation, the process of freedom fighting, you will offend so many people. So many people will offend them. You will step on toes. If you must be a genuine freedom fighter, you have to be ready to step on toes. You will step on toes. You offend your best friend. You offend your mother, your parents, even your benefactors. You offend so many people. But what are you going to do? Remain consistent. It doesn't matter the challenges where you're coming from. Remain consistent. You got to remain consistent. Your consistency is what's going to make you to overcome. We are human. None of us is a spirit. We are human. Everybody can make mistakes. Everybody is bound to make mistakes. If you make a mistake, you pick up you correct your mistakes and move on. You cannot say because somebody made a mistake, a slight mistake, because of that, you condemn every good work the person have done. Because of a single mistake, you correct every good work the person have done, you begin to condemn it. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work. I don't agree with that. Every single one of us, we are pursuing one thing. We are looking for our freedom. When you talk about the Biafra will contain every one of us. There is nobody we left behind, including all these politicians. When Biafra come, you will not tell them not to come into Biafra. They will come. When Biafra comes, including all these politicians, or Hades and Igbo, every one of them will come into it. You cannot build a border and say, don't come in. That is why all of us have to begin to look at that meeting point, where we meet. Where we meet is where we are looking for freedom. Our freedom is where every one of us meet. That is where every one of us meet. That is where we meet. That is why when you are talking against your brother, when you talk and talk and talk, you bring up your sword, take back your sword. Take back your sword. The people you have to be venting anger on is on the caliphate. The people that are putting us in captivity. The people that are making sure that we don't have our freedom. They are the ones that created everything you are seeing today. Without their noise and the rubbish they are creating, you cannot see what you are seeing today. You cannot see what you are seeing today. But when you see some irrelevant people coming to talk, you see some people, you can't come on the program then. The only thing you have to know is to talk against your brother, preach against your brother, make him evil, demonize him. Even every good thing he has done, you just trash it and say he's not doing anything, that he's this. No, it doesn't work. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. We know people who are working for Biafra struggle and people who are not working. We know the real Biafrans and those who are not real. We know them. Are there people who make mistakes? There are people who make mistakes. People who out of ignorance, they make their mistake. Just today, we see some people who support things out of ignorance because they don't have enough information. Sometimes I make some mistake also, even as I speak, sometimes I make mistake. But when my attention is being called, I withdraw back and I look into the information I've been given. When I look at the information, I see that either I'm right or wrong, then I'll take correction and move on. There is no amount of black men or whatever you say that will make me to step back and stop talking about the Biafra struggle. I cannot stop. Even if it's for me coming to talk to myself, I come and talk to myself. That is the obvious truth. But when you see people, there are some clowns. You see some clowns. They have started coming. I wish all of you can be bold the way Raphael be bold and come in. Raphael was bold. At least he was bold to come in and speak his mind. At least Raphael was bold to come and make a point. He came and said, what is his anger? You have seen his anger. Why he's angry? That someone ever mentioned his name when his speech was hacked. People were impersonating him. That someone ever said that he's one of those who was supporting those people who were impersonating him, and he's not happy about it. If the information is wrong, it will be corrected. You address it. You are not going to say because of that now you are going to demonize someone else and say that he's not doing anything. He's not working for Biafra. As far as I know, which everybody know, someone else is working for Biafra struggle, working for the association of Biafra, continue to work for the association of Biafra, not looking back, not stepping back. If you know anything you can do to make Biafra come, go ahead and do it on your own. Any contribution you can make, go ahead and make the contribution. Go ahead and make the contribution, whatever contribution you have to make. So, but when you begin to start to pick out point, you pick out fault, you are always busy picking fault. You see, when Rafael came in, when he was the thing that the most important thing that made me to allow him to come in, when he was talking about this 1 million match, that 1 million match, that Simon Epa said that 1 million match, that Ambazonia and Odudua are not involved. But that is true. Go and look at the video that is coming out from them. When you look at the video that is coming out, you will know that they are not involved. Go and check the platform of the Odudua people and the Ambazonia people. You will not see advertisement of that 1 million match. How can you be conducting a 1 million match yet? Even the Sunday Bowl secretary is not aware of it. It's not aware of it. So how can you be able to convince somebody that they are involved? I'm not against the 1 million match. It is a good move. If it is protest, that is your own thing that you can do, continue to protest. If protest is your own part, you can play a role. Your own role is protest. Continue to protest. Protest as much as you can and go ahead and protest. It is good. But for you to come and pick fault when something happens, you check for where your brother has made a mistake in the past, where he has made a mistake in the past, you bring it back. No. We have to continue to move forward. We have to move forward. There is no point dragging people back. Everybody is prone to mistake. Our brother Rafael have come here to speak now. Before you know, somebody else might come into this program now. He will begin to tell you what Rafael have done to him. Some people can come here now. They begin to tell you how devilish Rafael is. They will tell you one thing that Rafael have done this, he have done this, he have done that. But that is not what we are supposed to be doing. It's not what we are supposed to be doing. We are supposed to be focused, pursuing freedom. The major enemy that we have is the Fulani Caliphate that have made themselves enemy to Biafran people. They are the people that we have to be much more concerned about. We didn't make them enemy. They have made themselves enemy to the Biafran people, making sure that we don't have a life. And that is what we have to focus on and continue to focus on that. I appreciate everybody who have joined this very broadcast today. Thank you so much for joining. Share the video, share it to your family and friends, share it to everybody. Let them hear our view. No matter how angry you are, don't demonize your brother. Don't distract people who are working for your freedom. Do not. Everybody have a role to play on different directions. Our talents are different. Our talents are different on different areas. Our talents, we all have different talents. Each and every one of us have different talents. When you see the area you can be able to perform better, continue to do it. Mazen Nanekano said, if you know what you will do to make Biafra come, go ahead and do it. Let every one of us put our head together. Anyone you know you can do that is working, let us go ahead and do it. Let us stop this issue of pointing out fault. Let us not be busy spending our time to point out where this one have made mistake or where this one, even some things that are irrelevant. What about the places where the people have done something wrong that are working, that you have seen working? What have you done about that? What have you done? What have you said about that? Why don't you focus about on the positive side? Every one of us know that there are meaningful things that someone ever have done. A whole lot, he cannot count, which every one of us is a witness, including our brother Rafael is a witness. He was part of it. So how can you all of a sudden just wake up and condemn every single thing? And what brought even the problem that generated all this very problem was this same Jezebel that was preaching about Idu. It was the same Jezebel that preached about Idu. She was preaching about Idu, and Simon was taking his own time to find that information and get actual information he was looking for. Until he got that information, before he began to talk about it. But that time, people wanted him to pick up a fight. Everyone wanted him to pick up that fight. Everybody was telling him, pick up that fight, fight her, push her. But you don't just fight that fight without getting an information. If he has fought her at that very time, some information we have today, we cannot have it. If someone ever had fought that very Jezebel, the time they wanted him to fight her, some information that we have today, we will not have them. So many of the information we have today, we can't have them. Let us pursue that which we know we can be able to follow. Follow the right course. Pursue the right course. Support each other. Let us stop demonizing each other. Let us stop distracting one another. We have a lot of things to do. We have a lot of things to do. A lot of good work to do. We have a lot of things to do. Why don't we focus on that? We are very good. Every one of us have a talent on one thing or another. Focus on that, your talent. Pursue it to the actualization of Biafra. That is where every one of us meet. After all this fighting, after all this gossip, when Biafra come, are we going to run away? We will still meet in Biafra land. Every single one of us will sit on a round table in Biafra land. That is why you must not distract anybody that is fighting for Biafra. Don't distract them. Anybody that is genuinely fighting for Biafra. Not people who are making noise. Anybody that is genuinely fighting for Biafra, not a motivational speaker. Anybody that is a genuine freedom fighter, when you go there, listen to them. Don't distract them. Don't distract. If you don't have anything to offer or you don't have something to say, just keep your mouth shut. Don't say anything. Don't say anything. You must not, it is not compulsory that we must be speaking in the same tone of voice or in the same language. We must not be using the same language. We must not follow the same approach. The way Mazin Nnamdi Kanu approach issues is not the way other people approach issues. The way someone else approaches you is not the way other people approach you. The way you yourself that is watching me will approach you is not the way I will approach you. Everyone has a different way of approaching a problem. And when you're approaching your problem, you know, if you know that that's the best way to approach that problem, approach it in that way. The solution and the destination is freedom. The only person we treat as an enemy should be the caliphate who are bent on keeping us down. That is where we have to be concerned. That is where we have to focus. And I pray that Chukwuoke Kabiama will continue to hold us strong. Today, you see some people who we are on the same page, who we are on the same page with Simon Ekpa, condemning the evil that people are doing. Today, you see them turning back to that evil, all because all of a sudden you decided that Simon Ekpa has spoken against you, or Simon Ekpa did something you didn't like. Because of that, now you turn to people who you have condemned before. Those people who you have called them and called demons. All of a sudden, you change 360 degrees and you begin to follow those people you have called evil. It doesn't work that way. And when you do such a thing, what does that show? It shows the inconsistency. If you are consistent, when you see something that you do right, follow it. If somebody does something that is wrong with you, approach that very person. Approach that very person, deal with the issue, and the issue will be dealt with immediately. Nobody is above mistake. I am not telling you that Simon cannot make mistake. Simon can make mistake. He is human. He can make mistake. He's human. And whenever he makes mistake, if you call his attention and he understands he has made mistake, I believe that he's going to make the correction. He will make the correction. If actually he has made a mistake, he will make the correction. Certainly he will. I have seen him several times coming to apologize on his platform. I have seen him several times making apology and making corrections where necessary. He always does that. So whatever you feel he has done wrong, that you feel that this thing is not right, is not, go back to him and talk to him. Let the information get to him. It will be corrected. It is not demonizing him when you know every man and every woman, everybody know that he is doing the right and he's fighting a just cause. He has done a lot of good work. He's doing marvelously well. As he stands today, he's still the loud voice that we can hear. He's still the person that speaks and the caliphate responds. So how can anybody be fighting against him? How can you be fighting against him? How can you be trying to destroy him or destroy his platform or his names? It's not going to do you any well. It's not going to do you any good. It's not going to uplift you. It's not going to make you better. It's not going to make you look reasonable in anybody's presence. Instead, it will make you look irrelevant. Whatever differences we have to sort our difference and continue to move forward. Pursue Biafra. That is our destination. Biafra will definitely come. And every single one of us, we will meet in Biafra and we will celebrate as brothers. It doesn't matter. We will celebrate in Biafra. We will definitely meet in Biafra land. We will celebrate in Biafra land. Everybody make mistake. If you begin to point out mistake now, somebody might come in this program now. He'll begin to tell you how I have offended him, the mistake I have made in the past. Even maybe I might not even know that I've made a mistake. Some people can come and point out mistake. Maybe something I did, I didn't like the way I'm doing it. He will condemn me for that. Then you cannot say that because of that now, that every single thing I have not, everything that I've said is just, I'm just pretending I'm doing this, I'm doing that. Just like my brother Rafael was doing. He almost concluded. He almost called me names and all whatnot. But that is not how it works. I cannot take your word by the way. And not just like someone ever said, I cannot take everything he's saying. But when I weigh the percentage of the truth and percentage of the lie, when you weigh the percentage of truth, you weigh the two things, you can know where you can be able to hope. You can know where you can balance your speech. That is it. I am going to see you dig down and look it deeply. The fact that I know is that somebody was impersonating Simon Eber using his platform. That one is a fact established, which Rafael himself agreed on. But the person who was doing that, Rafael disagreed that the person that was mentioned, his name was mentioned, wasn't the person. That the person whose name was mentioned that was doing that impersonation wasn't the person. Then we're going to find out who the person is by the special grace of Chukwu Okabiam. I thank everybody who has been patient enough to join us. Tomorrow we are going to continue. And if you have time, please join me on my YouTube channel. I'm going to have a program by 7:30 p.m. Biafran time. Join me on YouTube channel. We can continue to interact. You can equally join the program on that very place and give your own opinion. Also join me on Chooks for Survivor channel. I also broadcast there. Try as much as possible to put your own effort, anything you know you can do to support the struggle. Go ahead and support it. The ESN fundraising is coming on the 18th. Support the ESN. Support the ESN the best way you can. This is the time to support the ESN. As you are hearing about the coming of the Fulani Caliphate, they've come invading of the Biafra land. It is not a joke. It is not a joke. Biafra land invasion is not a joke. The same place they kidnapped that prelate, they have done another kidnap in that very area. The same place the prelate was kidnapped, people were kidnapped there again just a few days ago. A boss was kidnapped in that very place. The same place where the prelate was kidnapped. What does that tell you? The military can never ever protect. Nigerian military or police can never ever protect you in Biafra land. The only defense we have is the ESN. The only defense and protection we have is the ESN. So on the 18th, please join the Zoom. Support the ESN. Support the ESN the best way you can. If you know any angle you can use to support the ESN, please kindly support the ESN. Join if your widow's mind is highly needed. Support the ESN the best way you can. That is the only defense force we have. That is the only defense we have. No other defense we have in Biafra land. I pray that Chukwu Okabiam will guide and protect every one of us, strengthen us and give us that courage and wisdom to continue to do that which is right. We must continue until Biafra comes. Our destination is freedom and nothing else. The coming of Biafra. Biafra will definitely come, whether you like it or not. And the issue of PVC, there will be no election in Biafra land. We are not going to be participating in any election. We are not part of it. We are not part of the election. We can never, ever be part of the election. Mazin Nanekanu told us it's either Biafra or death. Mazin Nanekanu told us about being consistent in our demand. Our demand is referendum. And the time to demand for that referendum is now. We are not moving back. May Chukwu Okabiam guide and protect everybody have watched this video. Everybody have supported this very platform from beginning to the end. I say, may Chukwu Okabiam guide and protect you. We will continue tomorrow by the special grace of God. May Chukwu Okabiam guide and protect Mazin Nanekanu. Secure him. Protect him. Give him strength. Give him wisdom. Give him more revelation. Very soon, Mazin Nanekanu is going to join us. From every indication, from everything that is happening, you can see the light on the end of the tunnel. And we will wait until Mazin Nanekanu join us. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for joining the platform. I appreciate you and I pray that we'll meet again by tomorrow. Thank you so much. And remember, let's see you tomorrow. By the grace of God. Bye-bye.
Are yet to wake up from your slumber or your sleep and get the point that we are exiting Nigeria. Exiting Nigeria is not going to come from the platter of golden plate. You have to sacrifice for it. And we are ready to sacrifice everything, including you, if you come and stand in the way of freedom. So you need to know how serious we are. We are damn serious. Some of you are not getting it. You think we are here to build political movement? We are here for freedom. Freedom comes with price. Okay? The only thing you can do is to comment on social media. Don't ever stand on the way of Biafra freedom. We crush you.
Their interest is suppressed. Biafra is the key. Once they can hold Biafra down, they can hold all of Africa down. Hey, freedom fighting, sorry. Because all these people are criminals. They're saying there is no way this man cannot be a criminal like themselves. They don't have a different breed altogether. They don't know that. I am Nnamdi Kanu. I don't do all this nonsense you do. My father was a very rich man, not ostentatious. I had the finest education that his money could afford. We are not poor. Have never been. That is why a poor man cannot be a freedom fighter. If you're not full of yourself, you cannot be a freedom fighter. You have to go everywhere. We must continue.